down my...
With them, if you work with 200 fighters, how hands-on are you with 200 different fighters?
It changes, you know, based on, you know, how much they need us. You know, a lot of the guys, we literally don't show up at the week of the fight. You know, something like Connor, you know, I'm out there 6 to 8 weeks. I'm out there and monitoring everything. And, you know, the people that we are out there for 8 weeks, it makes life a lot easier.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube? Boogie2988 coming at you live once again through the power of the internet. And this is my rambling series. This is my vlogging series in which I talk about life, the universe, things around us that are particularly interesting to me. I tend to do my weight loss updates, my life updates, my channel updates, and just about anything else that I feel like talking about in these videos. And I think this is going to be a pretty interesting episode because I want to talk about this BetterHelp situation, which is probably going to include a bit of an apology. I want to talk about the mystery girl. It's been on my social media. It's been on my YouTube channel lately. I want to talk a little bit about my health update. I want to talk a little bit about the state of the channel. I'll probably throw a few other topics in there as well. But I know a lot of you are always interested in the weight loss updates, the health updates. No number changes to show you. But here's what I will tell you. I'm super excited because I'm finally at a point, after McJugger Nuggets visited, after we went to the cave and everything else, I'm at a point where I can stand on my feet for about an hour at a time, sometimes up to as much as 2 hours at a time. It's still very hard. It's still very, very painful. But I'm finally at a point where I can walk. Remember, 6 months ago, I made a video where I said I'd never need that wheelchair again. That seems to be the case. I don't know that I'll ever be walking around VidCon, which is 10 miles a day sometimes, but I feel like I will be walking a lot more for the rest of my life, and I'm pretty excited about it. Certainly will never need a Mark cart in a store again for a really long time, hopefully ever. I'll probably never need a Mark cart for most of the things I want to do, and maybe hopefully one day never even at a huge con like VidCon or RTX. I look forward to the day that I can walk everywhere that I want to go. Now, the reason my mobility is up so much is not just because McJugger Nuggets visited, and we went through the caves, and we went through all the crazy stuff, but that mystery girl you guys have been seeing in the videos, I've been trying to build up her Instagram and build up her Twitter and build up her social media as a way of saying thank you for being a friend. And I know a lot of people want to ship it. There's nothing there to ship. We're just friends. We met during that whole McJugger Nuggets crossover episode. I was looking for somebody to play the victim role for those pranks. I was looking for somebody who could do special. latex makeup, and someone who was female, because that obviously adds an extra element to the whole, you know, scary thing that I was doing there with those videos. So we met that way, and it turns out we had a lot in common. So I've been going places with her to shooting range, for example. I shot shooting range content. I realize you can't show that on YouTube anymore because they do not like guns anymore, so I do not want to post that video. It might show up on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter or somewhere, but probably not here on YouTube. We've gone to arcades. We've gone to haunted houses. Silly places, things that get me up and walking and moving. And one of the ways that I wanted to pay her back was to help her build up her social media, for just being a really good friend. So if you guys want to follow her on social media, I've linked to it several times. You can find her every week. But I know people like to read into that kind of thing. I don't know why. I get it. People want to ship it. There's nothing. Sorry for that. It is amazing, though, to have someone who is active, someone who is young, someone who is a friend who can get me out into the world and doing cool stuff and getting me on my feet and going bowling and going to a shooting range and doing all that kind of crazy stuff I would never do on my own, even when I do with my normal friends. It's really rewarding and really nice. Nobody wants to play Pokemon Go with me, but she does, and that's cool. So let's talk a little bit about the state of the channel. So the last couple of videos I've uploaded should have hit their target numbers, say 150,000. They didn't. I don't know if it's just you guys are getting bored of me, you're getting bored of my content. I don't know if it's the controversies I've been involved in. I don't know. It could be any number of things. I have talked to a lot of other YouTubers, and they've all told me that their videos tend to hit their normal view marks. Say it was 200,000. For me, it's 150,000. But every once in a while, they upload a video, and it gets half that number. I don't know what that is. I've talked to folks at YouTube, and they've given me an idea that there's new bots and new algorithms, and the way they recommend stuff and the way they share stuff, they look for certain flags and certain things, and they don't like a certain element in the video, they're not going to share it, and da-da-da-da-da. I don't know if that's true. I don't know. Here's what I do know. If even just 75,000 people are watching a video I upload, I'm still going to upload. I've said that a million times. I'm just grateful to have the audience I have. Thank you guys for watching. I feel like at the end of the day, most of the blame is on me. I could be making better content. I could be doing better stuff. I could be sharing different parts of my life, and I've been backing off of YouTube a lot so that I can get that hour and a half, 2 hours of exercise. I've been backing off of Twitch a lot. If that's the price I pay, if the algorithm doesn't like me, if you guys don't like me anymore, so that I can lose the rest of this weight so that I can get my body in shape, that's a price worth paying. I don't know what I'll do for the future if it comes to money and things like that that affects me negatively, but at the end of the day, I've got money saved up. I will be okay. As long as I don't die from my morbid obesity, that's the priority number one. So I try not to spend too much time worrying about it. Staying active has helped that quite a bit, which will lead me into my next point, and I guess it's leading into the BetterHelp situation. I have now been 2 months on my new antidepressant, Trintellix, which I would have never got onto if it wasn't for the folks at BetterHelp. And I know if you're mad about BetterHelp, I will explain the entire situation, but I'm never going to shy away from the fact that BetterHelp helped me quite a bit when I used their service. Now, that doesn't change the fact that their terms of service is very, very scary. So I want to tell the story of how I got involved with that. I've been told by some people, don't do it, don't do it, don't engage, don't talk about it. I don't agree with that. I personally feel engaging is the right decision, explaining myself to my audience, even the people who hate me. You'll probably find something I say here. If you're mad at me already, you're going to find something in here to make yourself even madder at me, and that's okay. I'm probably going to say something stupid here because I always do because I'm an idiot. But here's the truth, and I see no reason to say anything other than truth. As you guys know, I went through a divorce, and I went through gastric bypass surgery, and my depression, my anxiety has been worse than it's ever been. The last year of my life, I had suicidal tendencies. I have had miserable stuff I was dealing with. I've never been so miserable. So I watched the Philip DeFranco show every single day. I watch Philly D every single day, and I keep hearing about BetterHelp, 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 BetterHelp. I trust Philip DeFranco. If Philip DeFranco is advertising a service, I might want to give it a shot. So I gave it a shot. If I remember correctly, I signed up under Philly D's code. And I used the service for a few weeks, and at the same time I signed up, I reached out to my brand manager, and I said, can you contact the folks at BetterHelp? If I like their service, I would like to maybe advertise them if they are helpful to me. He reached out for me. I used the service for 6 weeks. At the end of 6 weeks, I'd already done 2 phone calls with my maybe advertise them if they are helpful to me. The counselor that I got paired with, the very first thing I did was, what are your accreditations? What are you doing? She has a degree in social work and hypnotherapy and some other stuff, like 5 or 6 different credentials, so I was satisfied with that pairing. She talked to me about my eating disorder. She talked to me about my mental health. She talked about my depression, my divorce, and I found the service to be very useful in that I was texting things at night, late at night, when I was frustrated and irritated, and then I would wake up to answers the next morning, and then I could schedule a phone call, and the phone. After 6 weeks of this and realizing it was $60 a week and knowing the last therapist I'd seen was somewhere in the neighborhood of $200 an hour, this seemed like a much better deal. I was satisfied with it. I was looking for phone therapy. I was looking for therapy in my house. I trusted DeFranco. I trusted the company, so I started promoting them. Now, I don't know how many memberships I sold, but now that all of this has come out, that their terms of services are scary and bad, and a lot of people are concerned about it. And some of the stuff I've heard, like maybe they're storing my data, the stuff I said, the things I said on the phone call, makes me very, very concerned. I'm still using the service because at this point, it's helpful to me. But that said, I can understand why other people would be concerned. I understand why other people would not want to use that service. And I want you to know, I no longer, after seeing the terms of services issues, I no longer feel safe promoting it. Now, there's another step to that, and I debate whether or not to talk about it publicly because it's going to seem like a PR move, and I understand that. But here's the thing. When you make a PR move like that, it never works. I can't make the people who are mad at me stop being mad at me. There's nothing I can do to fix it. The people who think I'm a shady, awful person, I'm not going to be able to convince them otherwise. But I've made the decision that however much money I made through BetterHelp, I don't feel comfortable keeping the money.